Bonjour, aujourd'hui nous allons parler de après avoir, or après être, and avant de. Please take some notes in your book and be ready to ask your teacher some questions at the end. So what are they used for? As you know, we try to encourage you to vary your sentences. Just like in English, it's really important to have variety in your language. So they're particularly useful when you talk about routine or if you have a sequence of activities, like when you talk about your holidays, for instance. So, après avoir or après être are always followed by past participle in French, and it follows the pattern after plus verb in ing in English. So, let's see some examples. Après avoir mangé, after eating. Après être allé au supermarché, after going to the supermarket. And as you can see, we're going to have to look at that après être in more with more scrutiny. So, let's leave that for a minute and move on to avant de. Which is much more straightforward. Avant deux is always followed by by an infinitive, and in English it's before plus a verb in ing. So an example, avant de manger is before eating. So après avoir or après être. This is difficult, okay? This is going to be particularly challenging as you need to know which verbs take avoir. You know, that's the majority of them in French, okay? And which take être. So that all these verbs of movement, aller, venir, revenir, rentrer, partir, you need to know them, you must know them. They take être in the perfect tense, but also in that structure après être. Okay? And that includes as well reflexive verbs. So let's focus on être verb because it's a little bit more challenging. Let's do the example. After going to the supermarket, she ate a sandwich. Après être allée au supermarché, elle a mangé un sandwich. As you can see, the subject is actually in the second half of the sentence, which makes it tricky to remember to add that extra E, okay? So be careful. If you're a girl and you write about yourself, or if you're talking about a girl, make sure that you add that extra E at the end. The past participle agrees with the subject. After getting dressed, she brushes her teeth. Now we're looking at the reflexive verb s'habiller here. Après s'être habillé, so I do have the extra E because it's a girl again, elle se brosse les dents, who's doing the action, but also I have to remember to change the reflexive pronoun, okay? So if it's il or elle, I'm going to say après s'être habillé, but if it was me, I would say après m'être habillé. If I was talking to you, I would say après t'être habillé, okay? And again, the past participle will change depending on who you're talking about. So make sure that you have that well in your head before you use this structure. So you're now going to practice a little bit. So have a look at these questions, these sentences, sorry. Try to translate them. Focus really on the first half of the sentence. Don't worry if you don't get the second half correct. We're really interested in how you're getting on with these expressions here. So you're going to pause and you will have the answers in the next slide. So pause now. So here are the corrections. The first one is après être rentré chez moi, je fais mes devoirs. So personally, I'm a girl, so I would add an extra E. But if you're a boy, you just keep the E acute and that's it. The second one, avant de se brosser les dents, il prend son petit déjeuner. Here, I really don't mind if it's a girl or a boy because avant de is always followed by an infinitive. Après avoir étudié à l'université, je deviendrai ingénieur. Again, je can be a girl or a boy. Because the verb étudier is conjugated with avoir, I really don't care. It's not going to change anything to my past participle. Avant de choisir mes matières, j'écouterai les conseils. Again, avant de is followed by an infinitive. I do not think about the subject here. Après être arrivée à l'aéroport, elle a réalisé qu'elle avait perdu son porte-monnaie. So here in the second half of the sentence, I can see it's elle who's doing the action. So my arrivée, he's going to take a double E. Here, it's après être revenu de vacances, ils ont besoin de se reposer. In the second half of my sentence, I can see it's ils, so it's a bunch of boys, and therefore I need to add an extra S at the end of revenu, okay? So be careful with that. And finally, après avoir mangé au restaurant, elle aime aller au cinéma. Manger takes avoir, so I don't really mind whether it's elle or il. That's it for today. I hope that you found this video useful. Do not hesitate to ask your teacher any questions you may have to expand or to maybe confirm a few things. Au revoir.